Hi, Sosa lovers, welcome back. We are here again for a new online course that we are going to make today with my colleague, Edward.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back.
You know him more than ever.
Yeah.
So, we have a very special course for today.
For sure.
Right?
Yeah, foams.
And siphon gun foams.
Siphon guns. Okay?
You know the technique of the foams. The idea is to get very airy and light consistencies and textures. So today we are going to introduce you and show you all the possibilities we have in terms of this texture, working with different ingredients.
Absolutely.
So from emulsifiers to stabilizers ingredients and other else. Very simple, but I think very funny.
Yeah.
We are going to work in savory and sweet applications as well. And we are going to talk about each one step by step during the course, okay? As you know, you can download, if you like, the recipes. We have the folder in our website, so you can just go there and take the recipes. We are going to put in the screen as well at the same time we're working on. And we are going to talk about each ingredient step by step, because we are going to work with five different of them in order to understand better how and when we are going to use one or the other one, okay?
Also, so, people can ask by the chat.
That's
any
right.
Question, yeah?
Yes. We have behind the scenes our friend Jan. So he's going to answer you everything you need. If you have any question as well, we can talk online and discuss it.
Can start with lecithin, Soya?
Okay, let's do it.
All right.
So while Edward is going to start doing the first recipe, I'm going to explain you a little bit about lecithin. Sorry. I'm going to put before on the screen the first recipe. We're going to make bubbles using fat. Any kind of fat can be used as well. For today, we're going to use sesame oil. In the end, the soy lecithin, it was probably the most popular ingredient when this technique, the foam technique, appears more than 50, probably 20 years ago. You remember better than me.
Yeah, I know.
So, the first carrot, yeah. You're right. Soy lecithin, it comes in that case, is the lecithin that contains the soy. We found in other origins, like the sunflower and the egg yolk as well. In the end, it's an emulsifier. We use mainly to blind water parts and fat parts and stabilize them, but it's very interesting to use when we want to create foams just in fat base. It's true that before we was using in water base,
yeah.
But during the time we saw that it's better to use just in fat base, because it's in fact it's not a water soluble product. Okay,
so and it's more stability always.
Much more stability.
Much more than water.
So what's the point? We suggest better when we want to do fat foam base, just to use soy lecithin instead of making water base.
Okay, put inside.
Please, you can start. So Edward, as you saw in the recipe, it's combining soy lecithin with the fat. In that case, sesame seeds oil. We have. Mainly we put 1%. We used to put from 1 to 2% depending on the consistency of each fat in order to have more or less stability. So we put everything together and we're going to heat up in the bain-marie. This step is very important. The soy lecithin, it doesn't melt at cold temperature. So I think it's important to remember always we need to melt at 60 degrees. Then after melted, it's ready to use. We can use hot, warm, let's say.
But the best way is about 45 degrees.
More or less, cold temper, not too cold, because then it doesn't raise proper. But about 40 degrees, it's a good temperature.
Yeah.
So while Edouard is heating up the whole thing, we do a bain-marie in just for this occasion, because it's sesame seeds and we don't want to heat up too much in order to preserve better the flavors in the sesame. You can use any kind of fat. It works with everything, okay? So that's it. It's very simple. Once you have already melted, you can use every time you need. Tomorrow, day after a week. In the end, it's just fat.
Yeah.
Okay? Of course, we did already in order to save time and let it set a little bit and rest and just cold temperature. So what we are going to do, just remove, I think you can put in the center. While we heat this part, we're just going to move it and you can put in the center and see how it works.
Okay, we put the foam kit. It's this foam air machine. Just put it inside in order to create it bubbles, big ones.
You see, now it's a little bit foamy. Let me just do one small thing on the top.
But you can see.
Because we did before. We just remove a little bit this foamy consistency. But you see, it's just the oil. And you leave it raised, just like this.
It's important to put it in the middle of the bowl. And if the bubble is too big, you just do it like this with your fingers in order to stop a little bit the air, to create the bubbles, the small ones.
Yeah, well, mainly because the foam kit sometimes it has too much pressure. So mainly we're going to see after, we used to put this small nozzle that contains, it's not a stone actually, it's irony nozzle, and it contains very small holes. You probably cannot appreciate here, but in the end what it makes is the foam is a little bit thinner. So if you want to get, because of the fact we can do it, because of the elasticity and let's say the fluidity of the fat, we can get bubbles like this. You see how they raise? It's very shiny and very stable. That's the most important thing. Once we really integrate and we melt the lecithin inside the fat, we have 100% stability.
Yeah.
For this one, we can keep it for a long 20 minutes.
Yeah.
It doesn't move.
Yeah.
Okay. I want to say just be careful when you place this on the top hot, for example, elaborations, because of the temperature, it used to fall down very quick. So for now, I'm just going to show you how is the consistency and the texture. You can see it, very stable. We just pour it very slowly because they are quite big. So just be gentle with it. And you put on the plate like this. This, for now, just to show you, we are going to finish in the end placing on site the salmon tartare. Very shiny, very pretty. You see how easy, okay, and we have a beautiful consistency. I think this is magic, Edward.
Yeah.
You place this on a easy tartare or carpaccio.
Even you can do some octopus with olive oil and paprika on the top.
Exactly.
Maybe.
And then you can make
anything with fat.
20 euros more.
Yeah.
I'm joking.
Take this.
Okay, we'll just keep it aside. I'm going to leave it here on the table like this. You can see how it how is the evolution. And we're going to pass to the next application. Just to show you before see the next recipe, what happens if we use fats that they used to crystallize in different temperatures. So we can use this advantage in order to do the foam and then have crunchy consistency, like I'm going to show you now, because we did. You have the recipe in the folder as well. It's very simple. We did with chocolate and some butter cacao.
We put the recipe on the screen.
We don't have, it's not on the screen, this one. It's on the folder.
No, but it's on the screen.
As well?
Magic.
No, it's not. It's not the second one. No, don't worry, forget it.
I'm sorry.
It's just on the screen. Okay, just, I said, this is the chocolate. We melt the chocolate with the soy lecithin. You have the recipe in the folder as well. And after that, we create the bubbles. In that case, with a small nozzle, and we just let it crystallize in the freezer or in the chiller, up to you. So you just break like this, with a little bit, with a smoke knife or something like that, and look at this. You have this crunchy consistency. Okay, very interesting. I think we have some cake, Edward, in the fridge, if you like.
Yeah.
Just take it out, and we are going to use a straight inside on the cake. As a decoration, I think for sweet or savory, whatever you like, it's very interesting. Of course, it's chocolate. Look at this, we just put some of them. We have some scissors, very gentle, like this. Of course, you can already appreciate the texture. It's very airy, and we have the crunchiness of the chocolate. You know, just leave it like this, and because we're gonna keep this up at cold temperature for the grease, we have a nice crunchiness, and it stays stable, doesn't melt.
You can use also in hot, for example, for a duck liver lollipop. Put it inside, twist.
For example, yes,
crystallize.
When it's still when it's still not crystallized, dip something with it to obtain a nice coating, bubbly coating, and then when it gets cold, it's quite funny.
I do some recipes like this.
Okay. Very good. So we have the next one. Okay, you have that on the folder. Don't hesitate to take it a look. We keep for now in the fridge as well, and we are going to see how it finish in the end. Perfect. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So, what's next, Edward?
The next one.
Sucremul. We have this recipe.
Yeah.
So let's put on the screen the second recipe. It's a Malibu foam. we are going to use sucre moule. Always we need to do and we want to obtain water foams. Why? Because it's much better than the lecithin in water base, not in fat, okay? And as you are going to see, it's very versatile. We can use in many bases with a very low pH, with alcohol containing inside, on a very easy and simple way, yeah? Always at cold temperature. So what are you gonna do, Edward, with this?
I'm going to mix the Malibu with the sucre moule. We use about 5 grams per liter. Yes. Sucre moule, okay, and also you can use cold or hot, up to 60 degrees, and just whisk like this.
Perfect. What do you mention? It's very interesting to know. Sucre moule is heat resistant, so even if you heat it at 60, 70 degrees, you want to place it in something hot plate, some hot element that's coming from the oven or the deep fryer, whatever you like, it's very stable. So comparing a bit with the lecithin that we've been using before the sucre moule, it's much better on that way. You see how easy it is? Just mix everything together by a whisk, and it's going to start to raise, and the stability is insane, trust me. For this recipe, you can keep it easy for half an hour on a plate or on a jar. Today we're going to put on the top of a cocktail. I think it's quite magic as well.
Yeah, because of the alcohol. You can use and reuse and reuse.
Never put back, never add more than we need. Okay. That's very interesting. I think we can build a cocktail already because of the stability. So what are you going to make with the pineapple foam?
And just look in the glass.
In the end, it's like a piña colada. We have already combined some pineapple juice with some rum. And Edu is going to make a small cocktail with it.
So put some
sugar.
Cassis.
Cassis is sugar. black currant.
Black currant, sugar. And I just coat in.
Important things to note about sucre moule, you are going to see quite difference when we work in sweet or savory bases. In the end, it's because the sugar, it provides a lot of stability. That's important to know. So it doesn't mean you cannot use in savory application, yes, but the sugar in the end is like a meringue. It provides a structure, and that helps as well on the stability and keep it for long or longer, let's say, in the stable, okay? As well, avoid, if you can, with lecithin or sucre moule, both of these forms, avoid too much fibers in. So try to use mostly, let's say, liquid bases without fibers, because then it doesn't, let's say, the fibers affect on the raising. Wow, this looks amazing. A little bit more.
A little bit more.
Ah, of course.
It's alcohol free.
It's alcohol free? Yeah. Then don't put it.
No,
it's fine.
Then don't put it more.
Okay. So it's starting to raise. I think one important thing that I like to say as well, because before you see it, of course, if you don't have this foam kit or similar, in the end it's like a fish pump, it's important to, when you do it by the hand blender, leave it set on the bowl before serve it, at least 1 or 2 minutes, because it always helps as well in get more stability in the place you serve it, because it has already some structure. So leave it rest a couple of minutes before serve it. With foam kit, it's okay. It's quite easy. You can do it. Can I get another spoon, please? You can do it in a minute. You see, already we have a lot of structure on the foam. It seems like a bad foam.
Yeah.
Eatable bath foam.
I put it in my...
we can try it once. Yeah. Okay. And just go straight in the cocktail. Like this.
Did you have an umbrella?
I forgot it.
Okay. Next time.
I have a bird.
Oh, yeah.
Look at this. How nice. And the structure. That's it. It's done. Very simple. Easy. Clean. And I don't know, what do you think about it?
Don't move like this, put it on the camera, and that's it.
Okay.
We keep it this for later.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah.
Okay, now I want to say, what happens, Edu, if I want to combine a water base and a fat base? I mean, like a vinaigrette.
Yeah, you need both elements, sucre and soya lecithin.
Okay.
So you always make the soya lecithin on the fat base and sucramol on the liquid. And then combine and you get an emulsion. Emulsion?
Yeah, emulsion, it's proper. Emulsion.
I'm sorry, my English, I speak like a Spanish cow, but don't worry. You know.
Spanish cow.
And you have, yeah. And okay. You have emulsion.
So yeah? It seems simple.
Let's do scabbage.
We did already.
Good.
Let's see the list. You have the recipe on the folder. I'm not going to put it on the screen for now, but on the folder, you're going to see a escabeche. Escabeche is a typical Spanish marinade that combines fat, olive oil in the end, and some water, vinegar, and a little bit water. So what we have already here, it's this mackerel marinade in some vegetables. We did a very nice julienne with some carrot, peppers, green, and red as well, a little bit of any flavor you want to put inside. Warm temperature on the top of the mackerel and leave it marinate for a night. This is very easy and simple technique. So what we did in the end, it was just split the fat from the water part. We separate and we melted the soy lecithin inside the fat at 60 degrees, okay, as we did with the sesame oil, and the sucramol inside the water part. Okay, just combine together, and this was the result. Whisk it a little bit in order to have a regular
emulsion.
Important for these recipes is if you ever keep this or this after in the fridge in order to preserve it for longer, it's very important to heat lightly when you already take it out and you want to use it. That's important as well because if it's too cold, it doesn't raise proper. So a little bit of temperature between 30, 35, I think it's very nice and interesting.
So what do you think? We finish the dish?
Of course, we're going to end now the dish. No, you know what? We're going to do it in the end. That's it.
Yeah.
I'm just going to place this once it raises.
Like this, we keep intention.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, so let's keep patient. Okay. Like Edward's like it. There we go. But you see, in the end, it's exactly the same. In the end, it's exactly the same. Already, slowly, and we can do as well if we don't have the foam kit.
No, you can
do by hand blender.
Hand blender, mini primer.
Mini primer, yeah, hand blender.
Hand blender.
Very good.
The best thing is to put some clean film.
Yes.
Half ball.
In order to be clean.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Just like you know.
Yeah.
Good.
Otherwise.
So we done for water base and fat foams. We are going to keep going with the last. For me, let's say consistency.
A bubble?
Yes. I want to ask you what I need to use when I want to do bubble texture.
Yeah.
Without fat, just water base.
We need bubble.
We need bubble.
Bubble.
It's very simple. Sosa bubble product. Okay.
Yeah.
Just going to keep it this aside. You want to show it before?
Later. When we finish the dish.
Let's keep the suspension.
Yeah, always.
Bubble. So, I'm going to show you quick what's about bubble. You see, I'm going to put on the screen the next recipe we are going to do. It's the basil bubbles. Very simple. In the end, bubble, it serves to make bubbles. Instead of fat base, when we want to do with water base. So what Edward prepared before the demo, it's basil liquefied. We simply blanched the basil leaves inside the water.
Put it in ice.
Yes,
and water.
Exact. In order to keep the chlorophyll, 10 seconds. And then we blend it with water. Very important to strain. Because we said before,
we don't like the fiber.
We hate the fibers in that
recipe. In
that
recipes.
It's very important to, if you have time, leave it set a little bit, at least for 2-3 hours. If you do the day before, you just keep it in the fridge in order to get more stability, better bubbles.
Always be careful, never fat, because it's albumin base.
Exact.
So
albumin is a protein that comes from the white egg and it doesn't like the fat. So free fat, otherwise it doesn't raise too much.
Even a drop.
Even a drop.
In one demo, I make it with the same, I don't know the name of this.
The tube.
The same tube of the fat.
And you lose it.
And I say, what?
Sometimes it's good to show what it's not good as well.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, let's keep going. Again, important to know fat and temperature. okay? Not too much temperature. So now it's room temperature. We have fridge temperature, 4 degrees more or less. We cannot heat more than 45, 50 degrees. Huh? Remember that it contains egg white protein, and the egg white protein coagulates. And we, if we raise like 63 or more, and we're going to lose completely the structure of the bubble. So Edward, if you like, just show a little bit how it's gonna go. It's exactly the same principle base of the lecithin bubbles with fats, but in water base.
In that case, I leave all the air because I like it the big bubbles. Okay, you see?
I think this is...
You can hear the bubbles, yeah.
I think this is a super ingredient because you can use it in many, many bases. It doesn't matter the pH. Even if you like to do it with some very low pH, lemon juice, passion fruit, and long, etc., it's fantastic. Many kind of fruits, sweet, savory, doesn't matter if it contains more or less sugar. This is polyvalent for everything.
And just put the bubble with the liquid, blend it, that's it.
So simple like that.
Okay.
This is important to remark. Blend it always, no whisk, in order to melt it proper and being sure that the product is completely melt inside the liquid.
Do you
base.
Want to take ones on the dish?
I think we can do it as yeah? well. Yeah, keep it there.
You have there.
Kill us.
You see the color? We keep it in the fridge for 2 days with the aluminium paper in order don't have any light.
Oxidation.
Oxidation, so preserve the color, the green one.
Very nice.
Good stability.
It seems.
Very clean.
This is as well a standard dose for any kind of recipe. 30 grams a kilo, 3%, 30 grams a liter. Okay. Let's see. Let's take a small plate. Maybe this one, I think it's going to be a beautiful contrast. Red and green, no?
Yeah.
Italian. Yeah. There we go. Very gentle as well. I used to use a big spoon because of the same, because it's a big bubble. Big bubble needs a little bit more spoon, as you can see. Very nice, very pretty. Exactly the same texture. Maybe a little bit less stability comparing the fat vase, but you have really enough time to serve it. So just put a la minute and you have for 3, 4, 5 minutes, depending on the base, of course, to arrive to the customer on the table. Okay, good. So once we saw this one, we're going to talk about the next one. We finished for the foam.
Yeah, we have already foams.
Textures.
And we can start with spumas.
Yes, very good.
We told the first one, the cold one.
Uh-huh, spumas or maybe as you know, siphon gun foams.
Siphon gun foams.
We have two different ingredients for this. We call it pro espuma in the end, or pro espuma cold or hot, both of them. So pro espumas, both ingredients, cold or hot, in the end is for the same finality. We just use this ingredient for siphon guns foams. That's important to know. What they help, so in two, I think, remark three important things. The most important is about the stability. You probably know that at the beginning, the foams, the siphon gun foams was made with fat or with gelatin in order to get the foamy consistency. But the problem or the inconvenient, let's say better way about both, it's about the stability. Why? Because the fat, it's not really stable, cream, butter, oil, whatever you like to put it. And the gelatin, it's exactly the same. You have a very nice and intense flavor foam, siphon gun foam, but not stable, no? So these ones already, they help you in the sense that we don't need, sorry, we don't need to add any fat if we like. So when we talk in terms of fruits and some ingredients that we want to preserve the intensity of the flavor and we don't want to, let's say, hide some flavors and maintain the freshness of some ingredients, that's the best because this is neutral taste completely and you're avoiding this fat import. And in the end, it's very simple to use. We need just to blend it and straight use it. No? And of course, the stability, you will see.
We can put the recipe on the screen. For
we can put the recipe on the screen.
Corn?
So, corn foam is the last recipe we're going to put on the screen. We're going to make with the pro espuma cold. Edu, do you want to explain what you did in here?
Here, I have just the corn blended with the water from the tin.
Yes.
Just blended. and I put some milk.
Okay.
Then?
No, just, sorry, just to mention, it's not milk, it's water.
Sorry.
But it's fine.
Yeah, milk we can is put the milk. Other one I do yesterday for the chicken. Okay, so it's water, tin water from the corn, just the corn, blended and passed through the super bag in order to take all the fiber outside. As he said before, we are no friends with the fiber in this elaboration.
As well. Okay. Because of the nozzle, in the end, yeah. More liquid is it, better foamy consistency we have.
So you see, it's just the liquid. Okay.
Very good.
And so, then, plus puma col. We put 10%.
Exact.
Of the product.
This is quite a standard dosage. Why? Because depend on your recipe. If you probably want to do an infusion with some milk, cream, vanilla, whatever you like, you must think already in that it's going to provide you already a lot of foaminess, but not stability. So then you must play with the quantity of prospuma you put inside. Eh? And of course, if you like a higher, let's say stronger spuma consistency, just increase the dose. If you want something lighter, more like a sabayon or like a foamy sauce, just decrease the quantity. It's very simple.
This elaboration is freezable.
It's freezable, like yes.
Yeah. You know, always the siphon is finished at the middle of the service, never at the end.
This always happens.
Yeah. So it's better if you have another one on the fridge and then.
That's true.
You're
easy
safe.
On that way. Mise en place. You do 10 tons if you like, and you keep it just in small bags, and it's ready, okay, to keep working on.
We are now on the time for making 10 tons, yeah?
I think we can probably wait till
yeah,
later.
A little bit. Okay, so always on the siphon gun, you always need to respect the maximum of the siphon, okay? Never put more than the maximum quantity of the siphon gun. Always be sure this is still inside. Otherwise, when you put the air, you'll be in trouble. And then keep it strong. Always to charge maximum, yeah? And the good way to put the charge inside is to keep it the siphon on that way. Put the fat one, shake, and then the second one.
Something that it's important to remind as well is shake it very, very proper. At least when you do, let's say, fresh. It's good. It helps a little bit on the stability. It improves the stability if we keep it set for a couple of hours, maturate in the fridge in order to absorb better the ingredients, okay? But in the end, you can see, as now we are going to show you, it's very quick. Let's take a clean one. A small plate. I think it's gonna be better. We got it?
No, this is
not this one.
Sorry about this.
Perfect.
Put it here.
Yeah, I just said check a little bit. Do a small test before out of the
camera
plate, and you just press like this. Look on the texture. Look on the stability. It's very airy, foamy, fresh. You hungry already?
Not yet, but I like to try. You always say to me, try everything.
Yeah, but you know already this is good. Okay, so we have this this corn foam done already for the chocolate. It's hot already. I'm just gonna mention how we did because it's done. You have the recipe as well in the folder. In the end, the only change from the cold version, we need to blend it and heat it up 60 degrees in order to absorb very good the product. Then you leave it maturate as well for a couple of hours before you use it. But once you do this process, you can just put in some piping bags and freeze it if you like, or keep it in the fridge. Then when you need to use it, you pour inside your saffron gun. You keep it in a bain-marie. We are around 70, 75 degrees. That's a perfect temperature. And again, for the service, you just shake proper, always upside down. And you do the same. And you see that you get a very nice, foamy, and stable consistency. So I think it's very helpful because sometimes that this recipe, they was a little bit tricky years ago because we needed to serve it, let's say, a la minute, fresh, and go straight to the table, no? I think it becomes, Edward, maybe you know better than I, a very nice and simple technique to do for banqueting, because with one siphon, you can do 1,000 glass, 10 minutes, 20 minutes before the service, the last touch and to crumble the cookies,
always
and go.
Stable,
So even if it's hot.
Even if it's hot as well, but of course, I think the hot, it's better a la minute because of the temperature.
Yeah.
That's it.
But you can serve 65, 70 degrees.
Yeah, it's fine.
20
yeah.
minutes before and then.
All right.
So
let's start building all the plates. Yeah. So if you like, now that we have already saw all the recipes, we're going to show you a quick and easy application for each of the recipes we saw before. We are going to start with the tartare. Very simple. We have this bubbles oil. So for the bubbles olive oil, sorry, not olive oil, sesame bubbles.
Sesame bubbles.
We propose to serve with a salmon tartare. Very simple. We are going to combine already some chopped tartare. No, it's fine. I think I can do it here.
Okay.
We have some onion, not onion, sorry, salmon tartare from Alaska. Very fresh. Pico de gallo, classical, coriander, tomato, a little bit lime juice, and onion, green onion, just mix. I do it by eye because I used to eat this once per week, so I know more or less.
You do a little bit more for me.
Okay, that's fine. You have the Tupperware with you?
Yeah. Always.
So we just mix a little bit like this. Can we get a small ring for plating? Small ring?
Yes.
Please.
Let me check here.
A pretty one. So what we are going to do is combining with different textures. You see, with the tartare on the bottom, a little bit mayo.
Which one you prefer?
I like this one. What do you think?
Yeah.
Okay, just like this. Okay, a little bit of tartare on the bottom. I think we have, Edu, as well, some ingredients to put on top, like the Cantonese, if you want to show on the screen and talk a little bit about it.
Yeah, this is Cantonese. You know, this is a caramelized. Normally we put the sesame seeds on dip it in water and sugar for 24 hours and then strain and deep fry in olive oil, just olive oil, in order to get some
crunchiness
and caramelization. It's less sweet than the normal caramelization. And you have also
good pinch of mayonnaise. No, I don't need chives.
No,
I keep it for another recipe.
Okay,
good.
Are you happy?
This we have a big range of these nuts. They are very interesting because they are deep fried, and that makes that the product becomes a little bit wet proof. It doesn't get wet even if you keep it in contact straight with some wet product.
Okay.
There we go. I think we did as well some small leaves.
Coriander
leaves. Very pretty. We did a small crunchy in the microwave. Very easy with a pinch of oil on the top. Look at how pretty they are. And it provides a lot of volume as well on the plate. Just two or three. And the most important on that plate, this sesame oil, these sesame bubbles. Just like this. We just leave it cool down on the side, in between the salmon as well, and the plate. Look how pretty is this. Let me know, Edward, if it's not nice.
Yeah.
We have already our first recipe. We're going to leave it aside. Okay, just remember, with this, you can make any kind of oil. You can make your own infusions.
Let me take this.
Thank you. Infuse any kind of vegetable oils, neutral oils, and make flavors with, I don't know, spices, herbs, leaf, whatever, and play a lot with color, and so on. Let's put this aside, and just to remember what we did before, about the fat as well with chocolate. So these chocolate rocks that they are already on the top of a cake, okay, very nice and pretty, you see how they keep, but you can put it in the freezer and you can keep it for a lot.
The first recipe, the second one, the third one.
Yes.
And we go to build the mackerel.
Yes, combined foams. So just to refresh, look, the bubbles are already on. We have combined the water of the escabeche and we have as well the vegetables. What I'm going to do is just play a little bit on the bottom of the plate with it, and with a lot of the juice as well and the escabeche. I think this is very pretty as well. It gets a lot of color. But of course, in here, the most important on that recipe, it's going to be the foam. We're going to play with it. A lot of juice. I like the escabeche.
Yeah.
Do we have bread for later?
Yes.
No, I'm joking.
I have bread. I had Ramon from El Reggae give me some bread this morning. Mm.
You know where is the good bread, huh?
Yeah, we was working on panettone for the last 3 days. So keep in touch, because maybe we can do some demo for panettone.
Yeah. We'll see it.
Yeah.
Okay, let's place the mackerel on the top. I'm going to hide this after with our foam. And the foam is done. You see, we did a little bit earlier. I did as well, because we want to keep the stability. That's why I said do it a little bit before in advance, in order to get more stability as well. And look at this. You just place it on top. Now it's a cold plate, so it's very easy and simple. Well, we'll put the pinch more on the bottom, and we got it. So it's enough. Look how we get a lot of volume. We have a very nice structure. This is as well thanks to the setting. This couple of minutes on the bowl, it's very interesting.
Okay. Let's with the
next one. Bubbles.
Yes. Bubbles.
Bubbles in water base. Okay.
And just burrata.
And burrata, of course. Being basil, we couldn't do another thing that it was not a Capri salad, instead of mozzarella, we are going to use burrata. So exactly the same that we did before, just raise again the our bubbles. And we are going to dispose some tomatoes in the center of the plate, just like this, during a kind of, or keeping some hole in the middle. And we're going to combine, look, cherry tomatoes that we just baked for 15 minutes at 180 with a pinch of olive oil. I think, Edward, if you must and you can, please check some salt, kind of flake salt.
Yes.
It will be fantastic in order
to
finish
this. We have everything here.
That's right. As well, play around with some fresh tomatoes to get contrast of textures.
Patan.
Very good. From Mediterranean, of course, the best one. Tak. In the end, if you see, we are doing very simple plates on an easy way as well. Burrata, I think I'm going to do the whole one just like this. Look.
Oh, you can open it.
Just like this.
Okay.
This is burrata. Break it a little bit. I think I'm going to use a little bit more tomatoes.
A little bit more?
Yes, please.
The whole ones or the small ones?
Both.
Both?
Sorry. Very good.
Okay.
One here and one here. So as I was saying, we're doing very simple dishes. In the end, it's a couple of products and the touch of the texture with the texturizing. Basil, burrata, a little bit salt, tomatoes. And
you say tomatoes, I say tomatoes.
Tomatoes, doesn't
tomatoes,
matter.
Tomatoes.
You're from London, I'm from New York.
What an idiot.
Very good.
Okay.
Let's place now on the top our bubbles, just a little bit in order to aromatize. And in the end, some, of course, basil leaves. Simple, fresh, beautiful, pretty. I'm getting hungry, Edward.
Okay.
Very good. We have another one. So nice.
Oh, sure.
It seems it's not the first one we did,
No, I think
maybe a couple.
A couple or three.
Look at this. Let me know. This is not.
At great. The end, we make a.
Oh my God.
How you say a buffet with all the recipes.
Of course.
Okay. So.
Okay, let's do the last one.
No.
We still have one.
Yeah. Run and chocolate.
Okay. So. This is the foam. We have the foam made with the cold one with corn, a little bit chives, and we have some foie gras as well in the freezer. We did some slices. This is just bread, a little bit of crunchy bread. We are going to place the foam on the top like this, just an organic way. We are going to finish this with some, foie gras. As you can see, I just freeze it. Yeah? Some slices that I did with a peeler, straight like that. So we just leave, fold down some of these shapes, pretty like this.
Some chips and
I think we have
some corn.
I think it's behind us.
No.
It's fine.
Passion fruit. No.
Perfect. A little bit chives to break the color, just like this. And this is done. Simple, maybe some olive oil drops. What do you think?
Yeah.
I love them. Always remember Spanish olive oil. Yeah, that's the most important. Okay. There we go. Oh, we have the second, not the second one.
Fifth one. Don't forget to put this on the cocktail.
We finished it. We can do it. Okay, so let's go for the last form. Now we have this already with the foie gras.
And then chocolate foam.
The last. And chocolate foam. So what we did to share the chocolate foam, just a small, we call it melindros, Spanish melindros. It's just a passion fruit biscuit. Very simple, in order to dip with the chocolate. So what we are going to do, we have this aside. We're going to put the home foam, the hot foam on the glass with a little bit volume as well. And Edward is going to finish the whole thing with some freeze-dried passion fruit crispies.
Yes.
To get some crunchiness. And just freeze-dried passion fruit puree with a lot of crunchy.
You want to put one inside?
Maybe yes.
Yeah.
Do it half. Break it like that.
Mm.
Be gentle. Oh my God. You love this, huh?
Yes.
Okay, look as well on the texture, the consistency. This is actually very good for this time, huh?
Okay, so you think we put all in the middle?
We must do it.
For a nice picture?
Yeah. Maybe this one behind, huh? To avoid any shadow. Okay, caballa, mackerel with these veggies and the escabeche. We still have the bubbles here with the salmon tartare. Our fantastic capres, textures capres. And the cocktail, oh my God, you put the ananas. This is very beautiful and pretty.
What do you think, if we have a new technology, we will use the...
Do it, show it.
Yeah, let's to give it the signal.
Same.
And then, okay.
So friends, wherever you are in the world, you see how easy, funny, and pretty, and beautiful is to give a small touch and different notes and pinch of your plates. So I think in the end, with some basic things, we did beautiful and marvelous finishings. And of course, more than the prettiness, they provide you as well flavor, they provide you texture, and they provide you something extra on the plate. Because in the end, if we put some texture inside the plate, I think it has to have sense. And that's the finality of all these ingredients. So I invite you to try all these things at home. Feel free for it. And keep as well in touch, because we have many more kinds of demos coming soon with our...
Yeah, I think next week I make aromas.
You do it as well?
Yeah.
I cannot miss these,
so
of course.
So people can understand.
But it's good as well.
Yeah.
I mean, we can see it.
Okay.
Anyway, always remember, you have as well all the recipes in the website in different languages. You have Spanish, you have English, you have French as well.
Italian.
So you can, Italian maybe. As well.
Yeah.
So you can decide and you can see it and check.
The
as
ladies
well.
From the camera set to be closer.
Together, a little bit closer.
Oh, yeah, maybe to see
how I like it.
Okay.
So
I'll see you next time.
Thank you very much.
Thanks,
have a great
everybody.
Evening and see you next Wednesday, guys.
Okay, so
keep
bye
in
bye.
Touch.
Which one are you eating now?
I think one of each.
We can start for this one.
I'm going to see just.